Yes, students. Now let us see chapter number 10, circus. As you know, the round shape is called circle. But now we will see the definition of circle in mathematics. So first of all, let us see definition of circle in mathematics. Then we will see some related terms to the circle. First, circle. Circle means a collection of points which are in the same plane and they are at same distance from a fixed point. This fixed point is called center of the circle. Suppose this distance between this point and the point on circle is called radius of the circle. That all you know. Now let us see parts in plane. If we draw a circle in a plane, then suppose one plane is there, that is A. Suppose C, O is its center and this circle is there. Then this part without circle of the plane will call exterior of the circle. Exterior of the circle. And the part this covered by this circle will call interior. Interior part of the circle and circle itself. So circle will divide a plane into three parts: interior, exterior and circle itself. Now let us see diameter. What is diameter? If a chord, for that we need to understand chord. Chord means the point joining line segment whose end points are on circle. Suppose I draw this AB. AB is a chord. But if a chord is passing through a center, through the center of circle, then it is called, suppose this is PQ. So PQ is called diameter. And remember that diameter is longest chord of the circle. So diameter is longest chord. Arc of a circle. Suppose I am having one circle with center O, and if I draw this, suppose I have this arc on this circle AB, then AB, you can see that ABR, with the help of ABR, we can divide this circle into two parts. This part is bigger part. This part is bigger part. And this part is smaller part. So whenever we draw this type of arc AB, then we can see that this is smaller part of this arc. So it is called minor arc. And this part of this circle is called major part of this circle. So major arc A. So this is minor arc and this is major arc. Now, so you understand this segment of a circle. If I have a circle with center O and having one chord AB. So you can see with the help of AB we can see two part of this circle this way. So the arc AB and chord AB will make one segment. So it is called segment of a circle. Because of this, here you can see another bigger part of this circle with the help of major arc and chord AB. So this part is called segment but minor segment. And this part of circle is called major segment. So now you can see minor arc and chord will make minor segment, major arc and chord will make major segment. Now, so you understand segment of circle. Now sector of a circle. I have one another circle with O center and I am having AB points on this circle. And if I join these points, that means radius OA and radius OB and this arc AB. So you can see here with the help of these two radius and arc AB, we got this part of the circle, which is called sector. Here you can see two sector, this sector and this another sector. Another sector we can draw like this. So another sector is made by major arc and two radius OA and OB. So this is called minor sector and this is called major sector. So remember these things related to circle. Dear students, now let us see exercise 10.1. In exercise 10.1, first question is fill in the blanks and second question is true false. Let us read one by one the question and understand what will be the answer. First question. The center of a circle lies in depth of the circle. Center of the circle lies in interior part of the plane. So interior is the answer. Second question. A point whose distance from the center of a circle is greater than its radius lies in depth of the circle. They call say that the point, one point is there whose distance from center is greater than its radius. That means the point lies exterior the circle. Third question, the longest chord of a circle is the depth of the circle. That we already discussed that a longest chord is diameter. So diameter of the circle. Fourth question, an arc is a depth when its ends are the ends of a diameter. An arc whose end points are of diameter. That means the arc is supposed PQ. I am having R PQ. This PQ arc. Then this is the end point of diameter. So that means the arc is semicircle of the circle. So semicircle. Segment of a circle is the region between an arm and base of the circle. Segment is the part of arm and its core. So the answer is core. A circle divides the plane on which it lies in dash parts. LB is the Z. It divides into three parts. Any circle in the plane will divide that plane into three parts. Exterior part, interior part, and circle itself. Now let us see true false. First question. First question is line segment joining the center to any point on the circle is a radius of the circle. Obvious, it is the definition of radius, the point distance of this center and any point on the circle is called radius. Then we can take any point. This AB is also called radius. This OC is, sorry, OB is OA, OC, any other point you can take, OD, they all are called radius of the circle. Now, second question, a circle has only finite number of equal parts. We know that circle are having, any circle has number of, infinite number of points. So, we can say that the sentence is false. If a circle is divided into three equal arcs, it is a major arc. If a circle is divided into three equal arcs, each of a major arc. No, that is not true, that is false. Because you can understand, suppose I divide this circle into three parts, this way three parts, then each circle is, this arc is not called major part, they will become minor arc. So, this is false. Fourth question, a chord of a circle which is twice as long as its radius is the diameter of the circle. This is true. Double diameter is always 2 into radius. So, the sentence is true. Sector is the region between the chord and its corresponding arc. The sector. Sector, who we call sector? Sector is a part of arc, covered by arc and 2 radius of this circle and point. So, this is false. A circle is a plane figure. Yes, this is true. We are not able to draw any circle without any plane. So, this is true. So, complete this exercise.